Hi guys, this is Dr. Ahmet Ergin. I'm an endocrinologist. I treat diabetes every day, and I am going to answer a common question today, which is the symptoms of high blood sugar. So what do you feel like when you have high? Now, a lot of people who are dealing with diabetes at some point in their life may have felt that they had the low blood sugar symptoms, right? So it doesn't feel good. It's very easily identifiable. But today I'm going to talk to you about high blood sugar symptoms. Now, how do you really know that your blood sugars are high? Now, one thing before we jump to that, guys, make sure you subscribe, make sure you give a thumbs up, make sure you share this video if you like it. Now, back to the topic, guys. So a lot of people sometimes will tell me in my clinic, they'll be like, oh, doc, I don't check my blood sugar. I'm like, why? They'll be like, well, I can feel it. What's your blood sugar right now? They'll always be wrong. Now, you know, your feelings are not going to always tell you what your blood sugar is. So I wouldn't recommend just by going by your feelings. I'm just going to tell you that if you didn't check your blood sugar and you don't feel right, and what symptoms can be related to high blood sugars. Number one, you're going to start going to the bathroom a lot. Here's why it happens. Your kidneys can only hold on to sugar so much. So after 220 blood sugar in diabetics, if your blood sugar is staying above 220 for a while, you're going to dump that sugar into your bladder. And as a result, you will end up peeing a bunch of sugar, and the sugar attracts water. So you're going to end up urinating a lot, and that's going to make you what? Thirsty. Of course, so you're going to urinate a lot, you're going to be thirsty, you're going to drink more water, and you're going to feel like you can drink all the water in the world, you'll still be thirsty. That's a problem. If you don't have diabetes, you may have diabetes, so you better check your blood sugar or get tested. You're going to feel tired as well. Why? Because if your body is not using the sugar that's running in your system, it's like having a bank account with $5 million, but you cannot pay your rent. That's a problem, right? It's painful. It's fatigue. It's going to cause problems, and that's your muscles will not be able to get this glucose, and as a result, you are going to feel very tired. And of course, it's going to come with headache as well. Again, your brain runs on the glucose. The moment that your brain is not able to get that glucose, then you are going to be in trouble, and it's going to trigger a headache. Not just high blood sugars, but fluctuations in your blood sugars as well. Sometimes people will tell me, hey, if my blood sugar goes down to 110, I have a headache. Well, that's not because 110 blood sugar causes a headache. It's because they're normally running up to 200, 300, and then sudden drop in the blood sugar will definitely trigger a headache as well. So fluctuations are definitely a problem. Now, if your blood sugars are also running high, your lens in your eyes will swell and you will start having blurry vision. So don't think that you're going blind. It's totally reversible, but you're going to have blurry vision, and that's not going to feel right. Having said that, if you don't do anything about these symptoms and you continue to ignore yourself, and hopefully you don't, but if you do, you may end up with something like called DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. Now, diabetic ketoacidosis typically happens in type 1 patients. However, type 2 diabetic patients can end up with diabetic ketoacidosis, especially if they're on certain drugs that can make them prone to it, or if they leave their blood sugar staying running high for a prolonged period of time. What happens is we call that glucotoxicity, which means that the high glucose levels will basically paralyze your pancreas, and your pancreas will stop making insulin. So what are the diabetic ketoacidosis symptoms? You're going to have nausea, you're going to have abdominal pain, you may vomit, and the acidotic state will set in, and that's not cool. So basically, you are going to also have this bad breath that sounds like spoiled fruit, and nobody wants to be around you. So you're going to feel weak, you may feel confused, you may breathe rapidly because your body will try to excrete that excessive acid through breathing. Okay, so these are the main problems associated with diabetes. Again, diabetic ketoacidosis is the advanced, like the towards the end stage of diabetes symptoms on that scale. But if you are feeling excessive urination, if you're having excessive urination, if you're feeling thirsty a lot, if you're feeling headache, weak, tired, those are the symptoms of high blood sugars. Definitely blurred vision definitely can be a quick tip for you. If you don't feel any of these, some people's eyes are very sensitive to glucose changes as well, so you may realize the blurry vision faster than some other symptoms sometimes. So I hope that was useful, guys. So please make sure you subscribe, give a thumbs up, and like our video, and we'll see you in the next one.